Hi. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about notebooks and journals and what the difference is between the two. So first, let's talk about journals. A journal is a great place to record your memories, your happy thoughts, your happy times that you have and you don't want to forget. You want to keep that memory alive. And keep in mind, you're also keeping that memory alive way after you've passed from this life. So your loved ones are going to read this. Your children, your grandchildren are going to see your journal. You have to decide if it's going to be something you want them to read, because guaranteed they will. So write about everyday things too. You will feel at the time that it's just an ordinary day and it's boring, but I promise you, when enough years go by, you will look back at what you think is ordinary now and you will think of it as extraordinary, especially times when your children are small. You need to remember those times. And a special shout out to young people, Kaylin and Taylor, this is for you. It's important to start writing in your journal when you're young. I started writing a journal when I was 14, and I've got to tell you, I go back and I read my early days journals all the time, and it's so much fun to just see how I thought when I was that age. So it's really important to start your journal writing young. I always recommend people do things they don't want to forget to do first thing in the morning, because if you do it first thing, you won't forget. But if you think you're well disciplined, go ahead and try and write in the evenings. I like to write at night just when I'm getting into bed, because I'm kind of pondering over my day. And as I'm thinking about my day, I like to write about it. So if you think you can do that and you'll remember to do it even though you're tired and you want to go to bed, go ahead and try it in the evenings. I also think that having a pretty journal, or for you guys, a rugged journal, it makes it more fun. Pretty pens, like I bought these at the dollar store. Even pretty colored inks, like I think one of these is purple and one is hot pink, makes the writing just a little more interesting. And you can buy some pretty darn cool journals like these at Ross. That's where I got all of these, and they were all $4 or $5. And this one is even got it's got a leather binding, and it was, oh, there's the price. It was $4.99. So you don't have to spend a lot to have a journal. And the next thought I have is about notebooks. A notebook is a place, I think, for your negative thoughts, for anything that upsets you, that made you angry, irritated you, and you just have to write it down to sort of get it off your chest. Just go get a really cheap notebook at the dollar store. You don't necessarily want it to be pretty, because my suggestion is about every month or so you burn it. You tear those pages out, and I offer a burning bowl ceremony, but you can do something similar at home. My burning bowl ceremony consists of me using sage and smudging the area, and then we use a bowl. We set these things on fire, we put them in the bowl with a blessing, and we let the negative thoughts go. You can do this at home. Just go outside someplace where it's safe, set your notebook pages on fire, and say a prayer and let it go. And I mean, you really have to let it go emotionally and mentally, like let it go with your heart and your mind, and it should be gone. Because the thing is, you don't necessarily want other people reading your negative thoughts. And I don't like reading my negative thoughts. And I came up with the journal notebook idea several years ago when I realized when I'd go back and read, I didn't like reading my negative thoughts. So it's just a great way to keep those separate. And I think it is really important for everyone to write a journal. So especially young people, but no matter how old you are, it's not too late. And men, if you're watching this, men just don't seem to keep journals. And it's just important for you as it is for anybody else. And I think you'll get a kick out of it. Just do it for a while. Set a goal for yourself to write every day for a month, or write twice a week, you know, on Tuesdays and Fridays. Although I think it's harder to do that because then you forget when the day comes. So see if you can do it every day. And, you know, set the timer for 5 minutes or whatever and stop writing if you want when that goes off. Totally up to you. The important thing is just do it. Just do it and see if you like it. And I would love to hear about your experience as always. And if you've got any other great journaling or notebook ideas, please send them to me. Mention it in the comments. We would all love to hear what you have to say. Have a great day. I'll talk to you next week with the next topic in our Learning to Love Yourself series. Have a great day. Bye-bye.